It's a film that's probably going to generate a fair amount of controversy, probably in Britain. There'll probably be the Daily Mail going, ban this sick film now. do you foresee anything like that happening? Do you think it might generate that at all?
No, I mean, you've seen the film. I don't know. I mean, maybe in the UK, I think the attitude might be maybe different. I don't know that the Daily Mail you mentioned, but I don't know here that it'll stir up much controversy. That wasn't the goal of making it. You know, this movie, we love to make comedies, make funny movies, make people laugh, and you know, this is no different. But what do you mean, like the controversy of what there?
You think people might be saying, you know, oh, it'll encourage kids to go out and destroy their their parents' houses and get away with it, basically.
Yeah, I feel like, you know, the age of saying movies encourage kids to do things is feels very 90s to me. I think, like, we're beyond that. I think we realize that there are other elements that contribute to kids doing things, and the idea that movies cause them to do things seems so odd to me, but, you know.
And you found the kids through open casting calls. You were looking for unknowns, looking for people that no one's really seen before but could still pull it off.
Well, yeah, I mean, part of the thing about doing a movie, found footage or one of these movies, is that, you know, you're not going to use somebody from, you know, network television. It wouldn't seem authentic. So, you know, this is now Nima had been on board and we started doing the casting process. Some of it was open call. Some of them, they came through all different ways. I think all three guys came from different ways, but basically we cast a very wide net and we're looking for some new faces.
And so did you sort of take any inspirations when you came to make it? I mean, did you look at like the likes of Paranormal Activity, that kind of stuff, which is in that kind of format?
I think, you know, some the rules that this kind of movie has, or the language, you know, is something that's quite set up, you know. I understand it very well. I think it doesn't hurt to kind of watch some of those movies and see maybe where they might have even gone wrong, you know, and what I wanted to do and what I want to avoid doing. So when I work, I try and actually close myself off to everything else, and I don't like to be influenced by other things except for what I choose to like see. So
when you were sort of cooking up the idea, you said that everyone had sort of come in and pitched ideas, and you chatted about what had happened. Who had the craziest story?
Well, that was more like I would sit down with the writer, Mike Bacall, and some of these, and Matt Drake, and we would sort of brainstorm ideas even before, again. And I don't really remember who had the craziest experiences. I mean, we all just kind of came up with insane stuff, and of course, then you came on, and we all added more stuff, and it becomes movies like this, and I've done movies like this. It just kind of a compendium of a lot of people's different experiences askew, you know, exaggerated usually.